He has this problem. He steals things. He steals things from stores, from people, from places, and he can't stop. It's just so easy. People are so trusting, you know. You walk into a store and just pretend to be on your phone or something, and fumble around and slip something in your pocket, and you can save like 20 bucks. Whenever he wants chips or Coke or batteries or beer or cashews, he just gets it for free. He wouldn't be able to live the way he does if he didn't steal all these little things, and he can't help but feel a little proud. Stealing can be a real ego boost. It's like he fooled them, and now he gets to enjoy life a little bit more with what he got. He shares everything he steals with his buddies, and they don't even know. I heard stolen food tastes the best, and it's not untrue. You feel freer when you eat the stuff you didn't pay for. Thing is, he really can't afford that stuff, but it makes him feel so good to be sharing stuff with his friends. Or giving someone batteries for their Discman for free, and acting like he paid for it and he's being nice. He knows it's awful and sick, and if anybody found out, he'd be really ashamed. But it's like stealing has built a world around him, and he just can't stop. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
True story. This friend of mine, she was on her way out. She knew it. I mean, it was a tumor, so no going back on that. She'd been through it before. They'd said they'd gotten rid of it, but they were wrong. They hadn't got it. It just sat there and ate away at her brain and grew. And it was going to kill her. She would have these seizures. They were pretty scary. The doctors would give her all kinds of medication, but it didn't help. The fits just got worse. There was nothing else we could do. We just sat there and waited for her to die. Brain tumors are weird. Your head starts messing with you. It changes things. She started going into these comas. Well, not really comas, but she would just zone out. Sometimes she'd be talking to me, and then suddenly she wasn't even there. The sickness was making her memories come alive in her head, and she thought she was in India. She grew up there when she was a kid. They told me it was because the tumor was getting too big. But she looked so happy when she was like that. She could tell me what was going on, talking to friends, people that were already dead, having conversations, hanging out. It was like she was really there. Every time I saw her, she was in the room less and less. Eventually, India took her for good, and she was gone.